Good morning. Today we'll start with properties of fluids. In this chapter, we'll discuss properties that are encountered in the analysis of fluid flow. First, we'll discuss intensive and extensive properties and then define density and specific gravity. This is followed by discussion of properties of vapor pressure, energy and its various form, specific heats of ideal gas and incompressible substances, and the coefficient of compressibility. Then we'll discuss with the property viscosity, which plays a dominant role in most aspects of fluid flow. Finally, we present the property surface tension and determine the capillary rise from static equilibrium condition. Density of ideal gas. Property table provide very accurate and precise information about the properties, but sometimes it is convenient to have some simple relations among the properties that are sufficiently general and accurate. Any equation that relates the pressure, temperature and density or specific volume of a substance is then called equation of state. The simplest best known equation is ideal gas equation, that is PV is equal to RT. P is pressure, V is volume, R is universal gas constant and T is your temperature in Kelvin. Where P is absolute pressure, V is specific volume, T is thermodynamic absolute temperature, rho is the density and R is the gas constant. The gas constant R is different from each gas and is determined from R is equal to universal gas constant divided by its molar mass. The thermodynamic temperature scale in the SI is the Kelvin scale and the temperature unit on scale is the Kelvin designated by K. In the engineering English system, it is Rankine scale and temperature unit on the scale is Rankine. The equation PV is equal to RT is called ideal gas equation of state or simply the ideal gas relation, and the gas obeys this relation is called ideal gas. Ideal gas equation of state can also be written as PV is equal to MRT. For a fixed mass, writing the ideal gas relation twice and simplifying, the properties of an ideal gas at two different states are related to each other by P1V1 by T1 is equal to P2V2 by T2. An ideal gas is a hypothetical substance that obeys the relation PV is equal to RT. It has been experimentally observed that the ideal gas relation closely approximates PVT behavior of a real gas at low densities. At low pressure and high temperature, the density of gas decreases and the gas becomes like ideal gas. In range of practical interest, many familiar gases such as air, nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, helium, argon, neon, and krypton, and even heavier gases such as carbon dioxide can be treated as ideal gas with negligible error. Vapor pressure and cavitation. It is well established that temperature and pressure are dependent properties for pure substance during phase change process, and there is no one-to-one correspondence between temperature and pressure. At a given pressure, the temperature at which a pure substance changes phase is called saturation temperature, T saturation. Likewise, at a given temperature, the pressure at which a pure substance changes phase is called saturation pressure. At 1 atmosphere pressure, for example, the saturation temperature of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Conversely, at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure of water is 1 atmosphere. The vapor pressure, PV, of a pure substance is defined as the pressure exerted by its vapor in phase equilibrium with its liquid at a given temperature. PV is a property of pure substance and turns out to be identical to saturation pressure of the liquid. Now, don't get confused of this vapor pressure with partial pressure. While partial pressure is defined as the pressure of a gas or vapor in a mixture with other gases. For example, atmosphere is a mixture of dry air, water vapor and atmospheric pressure is sum of partial pressure of dry air and the partial pressure of water vapor. The partial pressure of water vapor constitutes a small fraction, usually 3% of the atmospheric pressure, since air is mostly nitrogen and oxygen. The rate of evaporation from open water bodies such as lakes is controlled by the difference between the vapor pressure and the partial pressure. For example, the vapor pressure of water at 20 degrees Celsius is 2.34 kilopascal. Therefore, a bucket of water at 20 degrees Celsius left in room with dry air at 1 atmosphere will continue evaporating until one or two things will happen. Means a bucket filled with 20 degrees Celsius of water will evaporate until the water evaporates and the partial pressure of water vapor in the room rises to 2.34 kPa, at which point phase equilibrium is established. For phase change process between liquid and vapor phase of pure substance, the saturation pressure and the vapor pressure are equivalent since the vapor is pure. Note that the pressure value would be the same whether it is measured in vapor or liquid phase, provided that it is measured at a location close to liquid-vapor interface to avoid the hydrostatic effects. Vapor pressure increases with the temperature. Thus, a substance at higher temperature boils at higher pressure. For example, water boils at 134 degrees Celsius in a pressure cooker operating at 3 atmosphere, but it boils 93 degrees in an ordinary pan at 2000 milliliter elevation, where the atmospheric pressure is 0.8 atmospheric. The saturation pressure are given in table. A mini table for water is given. You can see here, this is temperature versus saturation pressure. The water boiling will temperature will increase as the saturation pressure will increase. The reason for our interest in vapor pressure is the possibility of liquid pressure in liquid flow systems dropping below the vapor pressure at some locations and the resulting unplanned vaporization. For example, water at 10 degrees Celsius will flash into vapor and form bubbles at locations such as the tip regions of impeller or suction sides of pumps, where the pressure drops below 1.23 kPa. On the impeller blades on the suction side, the pressure will drop below this value 1.23 kPa. And if you see here, the water even boils at 10 degrees Celsius. So water will start to boil. The vapor bubbles called cavitation bubbles, since they form cavities in the liquid, the vapor bubble collapse as they are swept away from the low pressure regions, generating highly destructive, extremely high pressure waves. This phenomenon, which is a common cause for drop in performance and even the erosion of impeller blades, is called cavitation. And it is an important consideration in the design of hydraulic turbines and pumps. Cavitation must be avoided in flow system since it reduces performance, generates annoying vibrations and noise, and causes damage to equipment. The pressure spikes resulting from the large number of bubbles collapsing near a solid surface over a long period of time may cause erosion, surface pitting, fatigue failure, and the eventual destruction of the components or machinery. The presence of cavitation in a flow system can be sensed by its characteristics tumbling sound. So this is cavitation damage on a 60 mm by 23 mm aluminium sample tested at 60 meter per second for 2.5 hour. The sample was located at the cavity collapse region downstream of cavity generator, specifically designed to produce high damage potential. Energy and specific heats. Energy can exist in numerous forms such as thermal, mechanical, kinetic, potential, electrical, magnetic, chemical and nuclear, and their sum constitutes the total energy of a system. The form of energy related to the molecular structure of a system and the degree of molecular activity are referred to as microscopic energy. The sum of all microscopic form of energy is called the internal energy of a system and denoted by U. The macroscopic energy of system is related to motion and the influence of some external effects such as gravity, magnetism, electricity and surface tension. The energy that a system possesses as a result of its motion related to some reference frame is called kinetic energy. When all parts of a system move with some velocity, the kinetic energy per unit mass is expressed as V square by 2, where V denotes the velocity of system relative to some fixed reference frame. The energy that a system possesses as a result of elevation in the gravitational field is called potential energy, and is expressed on a per unit mass basis is equal to Gz. In daily life, we frequently refer to the sensible and latent form of energy as heat, and we talk about the heat contents of body. In engineering, however, those forms of energy are usually referred to as thermal energy. In analysis of systems that involve fluid flow, we frequently encounter the combination of properties, that is your enthalpy and your flow energy. So that is, enthalpy is equal to internal energy plus flow energy, where the term P by density is the flow energy, also called the flow work, which is the energy per unit mass needed to move the fluid stream, fluid and maintain flow. In the energy analysis of flowing fluids, it is convenient to treat the flow energy as part of the energy of the fluid and to represent the microscopic energy of a fluid stream by enthalpy H. Note that enthalpy is a quantity per unit mass and thus it is a specific property. In the absence of magnetic, electric and surface tension, a system is called a simple compressible system. The total energy of simple compressible system consists of three parts: internal, kinetic and potential energies. On a unit mass basis, it is expressed as this is your internal energy, kinetic part and potential part. So energy of a flowing fluid on unit mass basis becomes flow energy plus your energy is equal to, so it is H plus kinetic plus potential energy. So this H includes the internal energy as well as the flow energy, which is H plus V square by 2 plus Gz, where H is equal to is enthalpy, pressure by density, it is the same unit as pressure into volume, 1 by density is reverse of the volume. So V is the velocity and Z is the elevation of the system related to some external reference point. By using the enthalpy instead of internal energy to represent the energy of a flowing fluid, one does not need to concern about the flow work. The energy associated with pushing the fluid is automatically taken care of by enthalpy. In fact, this is the main reason for defining the property enthalpy. The differential and finite changes in internal energy and enthalpy of an ideal gas can be expressed in terms of specific heats. So dU is equal to CV dT and dH is equal to CP dT, where CV and CP are constant volume and constant pressure specific heats of ideal gas. Using specific heat values at the average temperature, the finite change in internal energy and enthalpy can be expressed approximately as, so change in internal energy is equal to C average into change in temperature, and change in enthalpy is equal to C average into change in temperature. For incompressible substances, the constant volume and constant pressure specific heats are identical. Therefore, these two are equal for liquids, and the change in internal energy of liquids can be expressed as a function of specific average into del T. Because at constant volume, these two are equal, so you can express in terms of this. Noting density is equal to constant for incompressible substances, the differentiation of enthalpy, if you take the differentiation, you will get this term. Integrating enthalpy changes, integrating the enthalpy changes become, so del H is equal to del U plus del P by rho. Again, you can see if pressure is constant, this term is zero, and your del H and del U become equal to C average del T. For constant pressure process, and del H is equal to del P by rho for constant temperature process of liquids. So this is up to here. Like this video, subscribe to this channel, and thank you for watching this video.